Georgia Dome is the site for a clash between the ACC and the SEC. It's the 29th annual Peach Bowl. As from the Atlantic Coast Conference, the Clemson Tigers make their entry onto the Georgia Dome turf, getting set to do battle with, from the Southeastern Conference, the 17th ranked LSU Tigers. LSU won the toss, they defer, and Clemson will receive the kick from Danny Boyd of LSU. Sam Sanders is back deep for the Clemson Tigers alongside Joe Woods. Clemson playing in its third Peach Bowl. LSU played in the very first Peach Bowl, a win over Florida State 1968, and a good deep kick for a touchback. Yonkers, New York, 5'11", 190, the backfield with Priester and Emory Smith, whose brother Emmett Smith got a big win today. Kenya Crooks, the leading receiver, junior from Seneca, South Carolina, with 29 catches, 2 for scores, and an average of 15 yards per catch. Jim Bundren, the only tackle ever to start every game his first 3 years. Both these schools, one more similarity for you, led their conferences in rushing this year. First skip of the night is to Emory Smith for a yard, which features Chuck Wiley, first team All-SEC, classic overachiever, junior from Baton Rouge up front. Stansbury, the leading tackler, third leading tackler with 90 stops this year. Pat Rogers, who had 19 against Tulane, 2 off the school record. And Mark Roman is a true freshman, has made some All-America freshman units and was selected the SEC Defensive Freshman of the Year. Gain of 2, call it. And stacked up for no gain that time. If you look at the numbers for Green, regarded as a better than expected passer. Third in the ACC, in fact, behind Kildorf and Busby. Let's this one go long for Woods. It's caught at the 44-yard line. He's the second leading receiver for Clemson this year. Priester and room up the middle. Greg Hill combining with Charles Smith. And has carried twice for a total of 6 so far. In midfield on 2nd and 4, short drop. And breaking off the pattern that time was Kenya Crooks, as the 22-yarder to Joe Woods demonstrated. Offset eye on 3rd and 4, and Green can run it too, but he won't get the first. He is dragged down. 4th leading punt returner in the nation, nearly 16 yards per return, waiting at the 10. And Falk with a fair catch at the 15. Led the SEC in rushing, 3rd overall, 400 yards per game. Tyler, the trigger man, and Falk, first team all-purpose, All-America. David LaFleur, an enormous tight end, 6'7", 278, and the leading receiver, 30 catches, 3 for scores. Up front, Alan Faneca, sophomore from Rosenberg, Texas, All-SEC and second team All-America. They say has had several games this year where the coaches literally could not find an error in their film study of his work. Falk with the pitch, dragged down for a loss by Adrian Dingle. Trevor Price, a transfer from Michigan, they say as talented a defensive lineman as they've ever had. That includes Michael Dean Perry and Chester McLaughlin. Howard Bartley, a steadying influence. He didn't play at all the last 2 years, a redshirt that had been great sophomore season. Dexter McLeon, outgoing senior, second team all-conference. Quarterback, the 93 Peach Bowl for Clemson. Yardage to the 14 by Falk, the third-ranked passer in his conference. 13-2 as a starter. Took over for the injured Jamie Howard last year. Well protected. Swing it to Falk out of the backfield. But Kevin Falk may not have reached the line of scrimmage. Clemson coming pretty hard. And a rather short kick. Sideways bounce. Great field position. Lead again with Smith and Priester behind him in the eye. And runs the option. Pitch to Priester. Cuts it back for about 3 or 4. And Green to the air has it batted down. First year man. Both wide receivers left. Green rolling that way and delivers incomplete, intended for Woods, who had good coverage that time.
This is a low punt. Falk might want to think about returning. What is it?
Belt skies this one. And again, Falk waving for the fair catch, has to make it on the run at the 21-yard line.
Kick, catch, interference on a kicking team. 5-yard penalty, first down.
To the 26. Motion from Tyrone Frazier. New tight end look, and Falk cutting off right tackle, breaks a tackle and stretches near the 30. 12th first team All-America in LSU history, Kevin Falk. Give again, heads right, this time hit immediately by Anthony Simmons. Tyler from the shotgun on 3rd and 7. And this one for Larry Foster at the 33-yard line is going to be about 4 yards short. McLeon again deep. Much better effort. This one, McLeon with a fair catch at his 25. Kelton Dunnigan on for a series in the backfield at fullback. Priester swallowed up for no gain.
Some good, big things are going to happen. I can feel it. The orange pants are on, doggone it.
Green with all day. Walker can't hang on. Broken up by Denard Walker. Shotgun for Green on 3rd and 10. Three wide blitz comes. Quick route by Walker. Gets a block. Turns it up. Does not have the first. He's a yard shy at the 35-yard. LSU elected not to put any pressure on him, and by far his best hit. Nose down spiral. Here's Falk. Right up the middle, near midfield.
I could go for a little breast of chicken right about now.
Vicky Savoy, 11, in motion. Rondell Mealy is in his tailback. Tyler fakes to him. Completed to David LeFleur, who at 6'7", can bring those down with the best of them. 36-yard line, 1st and 10. Serious drive by either team. Mealy, the backup for Falk, with some impressive numbers. Good for about 9 yards. The stirring LSU comeback.
Dead ball, false start, offense. 5-yard penalty, repeat second down.
And in motion goes Kendon Cleveland with offset eye. Good to Mealy. To the 29, ran through an arm tackle. Motion from Foster, Tyler with the option. Keats is buried at the 31. So Wade Ritchie, only 5 for 12 this year, but had a long of 54 yards on to attempt a 48-yarder, and he sails that one wide right. And this is on a 48-yarder, Clemson taking over from their 31. Green with a play fake, incomplete, intended for the tight end Lamont Hall.
They recruit him to block.
Second and 10, Green with a quick option pitch. Priester runs right into the tackle at the 27-yard line of Pat Rogers. LSU, which led the SEC in rushing, 13 on the ground. So shotgun and 4 wideouts for Nealon Green over the middle. Incomplete drop by Joe Woods, and they'll have to kick. His best, but by far Falk's best return. It came back 29. They almost got him this time. Effort. Falk passes up the fair catch because he can do this. Coming back though, they're 37.
You can read his lips. Donato was saying which player, and Trevor Price.
Ball is loose. Recovered by Clemson at the 10. Freshman Harold Means with the return to the 10. Priester weaving to the 6.
First and goal right on the 10. They can't get a first down. The onus now on the Bengal Tiger defense.
Emery Smith maybe gouges out a yard. Could be the last play of the first quarter. Green cutting it back. Lots of room. Touchdown. Guys can say that. Extra point by Matt Padgett. 7-0 Clemson.
Defensive end for LSU coming from the left side needs to keep contain on the quarterback. Right there, if he's able to shake free, there's nobody to the other side because all of the defenders are on the one side.
Yeah, I thought that was an interesting theory. He's probably right.
Magic drives this one halfway through the end zone where Falk takes a knee. Deans with the fumble recovery brought it back to the 10 from which they scored. Tyler breaks off a nice one, runs out of bounds after a pickup of about 13 yards. Green has the only touchdown on the keeper with 4 seconds to play in the quarter and after one. 7-0 Clemson in the 29th annual Peach Bowl. A couple of tackles, has the first down, and a couple of more to the 46-yard line. Just as Priester may be by the end of today. Tyler off the roll, delivers complete for Tyrone Frazier. The true freshman.
This wasn't Jeopardy, I was just curious.
Whatever it wasn't his position. Because he's back in football.
Left out.
Falk, and they're ready for him. Trevor Price trying to catch his breath. Second down, and Tyler hangs this one deep. Wide open is Savoie. Converted quarterback has first and goal, LSU at the 7. Savoie almost as big a target as before. He goes 6'6 and 239. Lone setback, Falk straight up the middle and powers to the 3. We're in the second and goal. Tight end is checked in, 87 for Nell Hampton. Mitchell for Falk, straight off right tackle, has an LSU touchdown.
That's an indication of power football right there, where you pitch inside and say, we're running behind our stud, both tight end and tackle.
But only missed one of 43 PATs this year, drives this one right through for a 7-7 tie. Clemson scores on the final drive of the first quarter, LSU right back to open the second, 7-7.
Doing it without him. He's playing some good football.
And he's perfect through the air. 5 of 5. Another touchback. Price and Harold Means combining for the turnover. But LSU with the equalizer on the Falk score. Screen set up for Emory Smith. And Emory rambles for a few to the 27-yard line. His dream is to naturally block in the same backfield with Emmett at some point as a pro. Priester, first down to the 32. Goes to show, yeah. Jerry DiNardo was right. It may well be the team that throws it the best that wins.
There we go.
Smith breaking some arm tackles near midfield. 16 yards. Emory Smith, the offensive player of the game for Clemson in the 93 Peach Bowl, the first game ever coached for the Tigers by Tommy West. And they stay with the hot back. Good for about 8. And the people who do the drafting have to consider bloodlines at some point in their decision making. Priester dragged down as Pat Rogers hangs on for dear life. Not among the top 5 vote getters, very surprising.
Big 12 competition to boot.
Green with a quarterback draw will lose as alertly staying at home. Nice string right there. Maybe one, if that, to the 40 of the formation, wide left. Woods inside of him, Green looking that way. Still scrambling, lets it go for no one.
Intentional grounding on the offense. 5 yard penalty.
18. LSU not going after the punter. They race back and try and set up a return wall, but Falk this time has to have the fair catch. High formation, Robert Tyler in front of Kevin Falk, who may get a couple of feet at most out of that one. It's second down and 2. LSU down only one more timeout. They need 10 here. Midway in the second quarter. Motion from Frazier. It goes to Falk, who runs out of room immediately. Falk actually takes more of a hit from the photographers that he runs into.
Out of bounds. First down.
But again, the official needs to make that call.
Frazier wide left, Foster right. Fake to Falk, throw it back the other way to LeFleur. Savoie throws the block, and LeFleur reaches midfield. Based on what we've seen tonight. Great drop. Hangs this one deep for Frazier in single coverage. That's going to draw a flag on McLeon. McLeon, probably their best cover guy. Second team all-conference. They think maybe a second round, potentially, NFL pick. Kevin Falk weaving up the side. They'll mark. Two tight ends. Mealy gets the give. And second down and six. Still two tight ends. They actually call one of them an F-back. That's Fernell Hankton, 87. Tyler keeps on the option. Good decision. He stretches to the 10 where he should be. Good for a first down. So don't think about anything individually. I think about what a great experience it was to be part of it all. Fake pitch. And Tyler breaks the tackle, reaches the five. Fine, gonna work. Tyler still perfect through the air, 6 of 6, 87 yards. High on second and four, play fake, in trouble and dropped at the 15-yard line on the safety blitz.
I love a quarterback draw here, Dave.
Tyler's done it well already tonight. This is third and 14. Rolls, and it wasn't a draw, but he's gonna keep. And he may score. One man to beat, and Anquan Edwards drives him out right at about the first down marker.
Now remember, they went with a pitch play. Clemson needs to blitz some people from the outside and their inside backer.
Tyler scores, but there's a marker down.
Dead ball. False start.
Yep. I don't know. That looked kind of ticky-tack to me, Dave.
Hard to detect. It really was. So a 22-yarder by Richie, who missed from 48. No problem here. And LSU takes a 10-7 lead.
But as strange as this sounds, that's got to be some motivation for Clemson. They got to feel pretty good about themselves.
Absolutely. They saved 4 points. 4:35 to go in the first half. LSU on top for the first time.
Look at the ball. You cannot afford a motion penalty when you only have 6 inches for 6 points.
Danny Boyd again with a touchback. Pitch to Priester, always a safe option. Raymond Priester to the 46.
Trailing.
Theo Williams is pretty quick. Ran him down from defensive end. Play fake, wide open and dropped by Kelton Dunnigan.
Actually looks surprised. Said what?
Takes this one back, fumbles. And a recovery at the 34-yard line by Anthony McFarland for LSU. That led to the Clemson touchdown. Tyler right to the air, juggled and dropped by Savoie.
Tyler has been on the mark. That's his first incompletion, right?
Yep, it is first six. 57-7. Falk. Edwards, a sure open field tackle. Should they get it back? Wide shotgun, third and eight. Screen set up nicely for Kendall Cleveland, who is about 5 yards shy of the first. Kessler kicks it away. There comes a returnable kick from McLeon, but the LSU coverage is outstanding. Right back to Priester, who follows up the fumble with a pickup of six. Strange, because they only started booing as they came up to the line of scrimmage, but that's when they were played on the replay screens here. Priester starting to get his rhythm. By Green. Lots of time to go over the middle, way over Joe Woods, though, who was wide open. Straight through the middle. Nice hole for Priester. Good for a pickup to the 48-yard line. Crooks, who's had a quiet first half, with a receiving leader, unlike Priester, a quiet first half, wide left. Green again throws one high, but this one is handled really for no gain, though, by Lamont Hall. But I would bet Florida State. Kick by Laird, an excellent one, because Hall has to call the fair catch.
This has been very unpredictable up to this point.
Jerry DiNardo settling for a 10-7 halftime lead in the Peach Bowl over Clemson. And from the Georgia Dome in Atlanta, we send you right outside the Superdome in New Orleans. And let's hear from the group headed by Chris Fowler. Chris? He also did break a couple of nice punt returns, and he's deep alongside Rondell Mealy as Matt Padgett starts the second half. And this from the 14-yard line is Mealy. Return to the 29-yard line. Tyler near perfect. Only incompletion, a drop by Savoie. And to give to Falk, who was hit for a loss. That was a mistake. That was a loss of four. Second and 14. Larry Foster in motion. And Tyler overthrows Savoie this time. Only two catches tonight. Haven't gone his way as often as you might think.
They split out wide now.
And in slot left, they don't go to him here. It's Foster making the first down grab. But this year, the third best offense in the SEC, their most total yards since 87. Tyler option pitch, a lot of room for Falk. Runs into Edwards. Second and short. Falk easily with the first to the Clemson 45. You mentioned, I can't recall the last time I remember a lineman pulling a hamstring. Maybe not the case here either. There's LaFleur. 33 of Clemson, first down. First down. Clemson's 33. Trying to add to a three-point lead. Good pattern and a nice layup by Savoie. Goes 9 yards. That's the catch of the night.
And watch the throw by. It's a little bit low. Look at him lay out. Wow, what a catch. All hands. And
that was a well of a catch, though. Look where he gets him. Second and one, 24 of Clemson. Falk should have the first.
That's just for over 1,400 yards. Great score.
Tyler keeping on the option. He gets inside the 20.
Then he feels inclined not to pitch.
Kept it for four. Sends Foster in motion. Movement.
Dead ball. False start. Offense. 5-yard penalty.
Just jumped early. Savoie in motion. Tyler hangs one up over the head of Foster. In their entire Clemson career. Double-figure tackles all but three games in his 2 years. Tyler on a roll, fires, and dropped in the back of the end zone by LaFleur.
Tough break.
Tyler might have scored if he kept it, but he made the right decision. 40-yarder by Richie is blocked. Picked up by the holder, Casey Tabor, but Clemson takes over. By Green in the first half. Comes up with another big one. Priester cuts back. Boy, very can do something with the block. First man through is the fullback, Emory Smith. Along with his thoughts.
Still shaking his head.
Thinking it should be 17-7. But instead, Emory Smith drives for a first down. Priester, who says, body leaned by Priester, got him four instead of maybe two. Second and six, incomplete, two call for Woods. And Nealon Green in the shotgun with Priester to his left on a third and six. Incomplete over the middle, again intended for Joe Wood. In. And again, hangs it high enough to force the fair catch. Edward defense creeping up, showing blitz. Frazier across in motion. Good for the lone setback. Falk, who has not had much room. Settles for one, maybe two here. Three receivers right side of the formation. They bring Foster back left in motion. And give it to Kevin Falk. Squeezes off left tackle and maybe gets two more to the 40. Still some negotiating going on over a contractual buyout with Vandy. Tyler steps up and keeps and has the first down and a lot more. 22 yarder by Tyler. Nine carries for 43 yards tonight. LaFleur hangs on to this one. Got another LSU first down. Bust through a couple of tackles. Reaches the Clemson 46.
That's only three a game. So he was underutilized, in my opinion.
Simmons, who is Keith Brooking of Georgia Tech. Pretty good demonstration why tonight. Tyler deep for LaFleur. And no flag. They're going to say incidental contact and no interference. Third and 17. Wrestling match going on, and it's broken up by McLeon. Will they call this a fumble? It was Nemesis Bates wrestling with McLeon. Outside his 10, if you can. Too much on this one.
That was the way it was going to be. We certainly wouldn't have anticipated those graphics in terms of the numbers.
Quick turn in for the first catch tonight by Kenya Crooks. Should be entertaining. Hayden Fry and Spike Dykes always make it so. Spinning forward is Smith and should have the first. 32, first and 10. Damon Priester runs right into Greg Hill. Just doesn't want to go down. Second and nine with first wide right. Goes to the left. Option pitch. Priester. Across the 40. Going to be third and short. That's the good news. Third and one. Priester may not have it. I'm not sure he got there before Rodgers met him.
Against them.
Well, they improved the spot a little bit, and it is first down Clemson. Dunnigan in at fullback as the flag flies. Harry, this will be holding Clemson. Designated by Successful Farming magazine. Twice an All-American. Second and 18, Green from the shotgun. And again, breaking off the pattern was Kenya Crooks. That's the second time we've seen that. Green chased and dropped by Charles Smith. 15 minutes to go in the 96 Peach Bowl. 10-7 LSU. High enough to take advantage, though. Falk lets this one roll, and roll it does. All the way to the 12-yard line. So LSU backed up a bit. Savoy across in motion. Tyler off the play fake. And another drop by LaFleur. Also, they have a much more comfortable 10-point lead instead. Backed up, leading by just three, but they call on number three. Falk with a flag down has about 13 yards of the first down. To talk on Mr. Falk, as you see the holding. Great spot for a takeaway here, if they can manage it. Tyler throwing from his own end zone. It will be overthrown, intended for Frazier. Big third down here, though. Stay conservative, give it to Falk. He has a little room off the right side. Now chased down and dropped at the 14-yard line. And Clemson sets up for a return. Great kick. McLeon made the first man miss. Into LSU territory, fumbles, but gets it back at the 43.
Dead ball. False start. Offense. 5-yard penalty.
Smith and Priester in the eye. Gives to Emory Smith. And running comparison and the turnover comparison is pretty obvious when you see the results. They run the reverse for Brian Wofford. Two-time 400-meter state champ. And will take care of those aspects of the game. Third and nine on the ground. Priester runs right over Greg Hill, but is going to be 3 yards short of the first down mark. But alas, no fake punt. Great job of hanging it up, though, and right where he... Tyler, nice catch by Tyrone Frazier of an underthrown ball. One of two tight end sets. As Kendall Cleveland gets the call, and walk. Cut back. Edwards making his third tackle in a row. So LSU, which began at their own 10, nice job gouging it out, giving themselves some breathing room and milking the clock now under the 10-minute mark. This is a big third and three. Tyler caught somehow by Frazier, but not for the first down. Frazier left baseball. Cleon gave it up this year to concentrate strictly on football. Great kick. Woods unable to reverse field, and he is dropped at the 9-yard line. They've been outgained in the second half, 132-40 by LSU. And they're 90 yards away, trailing by three. Nice chunk here on the toss to Smith for the 28. Good look at the family resemblance there. Emory out, replaced by Dunnigan. As Priester is gang tackled and moves that pile forward 5 yards. Mercy for the 41. 127 and counting for Priester. Batted down.
Downside is when you're in the pocket. Pass is getting knocked down.
Here comes Priester left side and drags Mike Sutton forward near the marker. Under 7 minutes. Down by three, needing one to keep the drive going. First man through will have an easy first down gain, and it's Kelton Dunnigan.
I think there's a fatigue factor setting in for the LSU defense.
Green play action, nowhere to go. Couldn't avoid the sack. He's run down by McFarland. All the points have been scored at the other end zone, the one that Clemson is going away from. So they're headed toward the LSU section now. Option pitch, Priester with room, needs a block, gets it from Crooks, and forward to the 44. Crooks and Woods come wide left. And they stay in the eye and pitch it to Priester, who is caught and looked immediately to pitch it back to Green, but he couldn't get away from Cedric Donaldson at the 20. Falk should have let that one go. He muffed it and returns it from the 1 to the 10.
Rethink.
The receiver signaled for a fair catch and ran with the ball. Delay a game. Half the distance, first down.
Drive in a row, couldn't get any worse. Tyler sneaking forward maybe to the 2. Engraved out at the moment, another sneak by Tyler, who got past the initial wall and gets 5 yards. Hit the snap with 5, no gain.
On the night, almost 43, he's done a nice job.
Low and returnable for Woods. And the return will get him inside the 40 of LSU on a 40-yard kick. Maybe he'll get a chance for redemption. Pitch to Priester. Raymond Priester bowls ahead near the 30. Not much this time for Emory Smith. Whistles and flags.
Dead ball. False start. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Repeat third down.
All right, offset on. Green rolling right and fires. Had Wofford open and just overthrew him, even with the full layout. A redshirt freshman from Lexington, South Carolina. Here it comes from 52 to tie it at 10. Blocked. Roman out of midair returns it to the Clemson 45.
That's not the big issue right now. The big block is the play of the game. He's done an outstanding job with this program. And to think that their two key players, Tyler and Falk, are both sophomores. It would appear the best is yet to come.
And a bit of a bath as he heads to congratulate Tommy West for a hard-fought defeat. Clemson will end its 96 season at 7-5. Another close Peach Bowl. LSU ending an ACC run of 4 wins in a row. So for Todd Christensen and Pam Ward, Dave Barnett saying so long from Atlanta, where the final score for LSU, a 10-7 victory over Clemson. Sealed by the block. Coming up next, SportsCenter. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.